It's a bantamweight matchup between Frankie Sines and Eddie Wineland. Eddie Wineland, pumped up, very confident, and ready to battle in the octagon.
This guy has inhuman cardio. The pace in which he keeps is absolutely breathtaking.
Eddie White back in the octagon. Frankie Sines, very focused, well prepared, and looking for a big victory tonight.
This guy has lightning fast hand speed. His combinations come swiftly and from all angles.
Frankie Sines, set for this bantamweight confrontation. Our tale of the tape for this bantamweight fight. Wineland is 31, Sines is 35. Wineland is 1 inch taller. He will have a 3-inch reach advantage. Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 21 wins, 11 losses, and 1 draw. He stands 5'7" tall, weighing at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Chesterton, Indiana, now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. A mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 11 wins, 3 losses. He stands 5'6" tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Frankie Sines! And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Mario.
Referee for this bantamweight fight here tonight in Chicago, Illinois. 3-round fight. White trunks for Wineland, black trunks for Sines.
Eddie Wineland is already a veteran of the sport. He has over 20 pro fights and was the very first WEC bantamweight champion. He's a very accomplished wrestler with powerful strikes.
Wineland with the 1-2.
Oh, man, with that right leg kick. And separate.
Solid leg kick by Wineland.
Wow, look at that takedown, man. Into full guard.
Joe, they get up.
Tagged him.
Caught him again.
The flying knee.
Now he connects with the left.
Wow, what a back and forth exchange.
Wineland with the good knee to the body. He gets the over under.
And they move out of the clinch.
Big swing and a miss by Sines.
Oh, he's hit!
big right hand. Man, he just missed.
There's a big left hand.
Oh, that one hurt.
Oh, what an exchange.
Hard jab.
Nasty combinations here. Beautiful hook.
Oh, oh. Combination. Oh, and he lands the head kick.
Oh, flying knee. Tying him up here in the clinch. Tries for a low single.
Sainz gets the takedown late in this round. Nicely done with the right, yep. Final 15 seconds. And that'll be the end of round number one.
Let's take a look at some of the action here. And here's a nice shot, lands perfectly. And here's another clean shot that lands. And another perfectly placed strike. What a great round. This fight is really shaping up.
The lovely Brittany getting us set for round number two.
Go,
all right, round two.
Look for him to go on the attack early in this round, try to pick up where he left off in the last round. His opponent was dazed and in big trouble when that round ended. One, two.
Sainz's left eye looks like it's really starting to swell up here. And again, he connects. And there's a nice straight five wind.
Look at that.
How good is that?
Uh-oh.
Oh, he's got his
back.
Back.
There he goes.
Back to mount again.
He's got full... Oh, nope. Half guard. And now he's going to try to stand up, and he does.
And the clinch. Nice knees to the body.
Joni lands another takedown here. Outstanding wrestling.
And look out for the guillotine.
Just over three now. Nice work from the body. He's stacking him here, looking for an opening.
Wow. Back up to the feet.
Wineland gets caught with a kick.
Very nice kicks. And he's down.
He postures up.
And back up to his feet.
And he comes over the top to the head. And connects with the jab.
Good inside leg kick.
Strong kicks by Sainz.
Both men landing in that exchange. Look at the bruising on his right outer thigh.
Excellent jab by Sainz.
He lands a huge left. Big shot.
Swing and a miss.
Oh, beautiful uppercut.
Yep.
Oh, he missed that kick.
Good leg kick by Wyman. Gotta watch out and check those leg kicks, Joe. You can't take too many of those. Wyman gets hit with the kick.
He's really doing a good job of controlling distance and getting off these shots. His leg kicks are outstanding. I mean, he's got great technique on him. Good takedown defense.
15 seconds. And right into the Muay Thai clinch. He lands a hook from the clinch. Round two in the books.
Good.
some water.
Listen, you're killing him with your...
And here's a nice single leg takedown. And here we see a perfectly executed trip. And let's look at that from a different angle. Incredible highlights in that round.
The beautiful Ariani getting us set for round number three.
Here we go, final round. You ready? You ready? Let's
5 minutes left.
Joe, we're coming off a pretty good round. It'd be great to see more of the same as the fight continues.
Decent action in that last round, and yes, I would like to see more of the same in this next.
Wineland with the big leg kick.
The jab connects.
Sines with yet another leg kick.
Good body shot.
Great left by Sines.
They are exchanging here, Mike. That bruise on his outer thigh is really starting to swell up bad. Throwing it to the body there. Inside leg kick lands.
Again with that inside leg kick. Another good strike.
Feints with the kick.
Lightning quick with the hands.
Wineland with the solid leg kick.
Looking for the suplex. He's doing a great job of being unpredictable and mixing things up here.
Good inside leg kick by Wineland. Eddie Wineland's aware that he is behind on the judges' scorecards, so he's going to look for the finish any way he can.
He's got to either get a submission or get the knockout because he's not going to get a decision.
Knee to the body.
Big punch. Doing a good...
He's got him hurt! And he goes down. He's in big trouble here.
Oh, he's out!
It's over!
Huge right hand victory.
Time now for our fight replay.
And let's take a look at the replay. This is the shot that drops him. Perfect technique. He's clearly in big, big trouble. Let's take a look at it one more time. Here's the knockdown. Vicious strike. Look at this. Boom! And he's out.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Lomasaki's called a stop in this contest at 2 minutes, 47 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by knockout, Eddie Wineland!
Eddie Wineland wins by knockout.
Up next, it's a strawweight matchup between Felice Herring and Kalen Curran.
Kalen Curran.
Coming off a great training camp and feels outstanding.
This girl has amazing cardio and stamina. It is one of her best assets. She keeps a very fast pace, and you can literally see opponents start to wilt in the second and third round when they're being forced to try to keep up with her.
Kalen Curran
enters the octagon, set for tonight's fight.
Set to make her way to the octagon. She's coming off a great training camp, feels very sharp with her skills, and is really looking to impress tonight and earn a big UFC victory.
This girl has excellent footwork. She is very difficult to get a hold of, very difficult to keep up against the cage, and her footwork, both moving in and out and side to side, are outstanding. She's very difficult to catch cleanly and excellent at closing the distance and landing her own strikes.
Our tail of the tape for this strawweight battle. Curran is 24. Herrick is 31. The rest is virtually identical. And with the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC strawweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This woman is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 4 wins, 2 losses. She stands 5 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 115 pounds. Fighting out of Inland Beach, Hawaii, Kalen Curran. And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner. A mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 10 wins, 6 losses. She stands 5 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 115 pounds. Fighting out of Crystal Lake, Illinois, Felice Lil Bulldog. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Levine.
Eve Levine, our referee, for this strawweight battle here tonight inside the United Center in Chicago, Illinois.
Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
White trunks for Curran, black trunks for Harriet. That huge head kick was blocked.
Misses with the kick.
Herrick gets hit with that inside leg kick.
Nice leg kick.
And again
with the leg kick.
Curran gets caught by the inside leg kick. Joe, that's another solid kick.
Nice inside leg kick, not even telegraphed.
Good kick.
Nice jab by Harry. Curran with the double jab.
Nice leg kick.
Able to just get out of the way.
Under 3 on the clock, round 1. Nice left hand.
Good leg kick.
Curran with the single leg takedown.
Just over 2 remain.
Nice inside leg kick.
Joe, that's a solid leg kick by Curran.
Nicely done.
I need you to pay attention.
Good lead left.
Nice inside leg kick, yep.
Curran gets hit by that right kick. Solid straight by Harry. back and forth. Herrick's blocked that strike. That's a good kick.
Solid leg kick.
And they're free.
Misses the takedown.
Nice lead hook by Herrick. Joe, she's really staying busy on her feet. Curran with a good straight.
Knee to the body. Good shot.
Joe, she's found an opening. And she continues to throw leg kicks. And they're starting to do a bit of damage.
First round in the books.
There's a nice leg kick. And here's another beautiful leg kick. And there's another excellent leg kick. Very impressive striking going on in that round.
And the lovely Brittany gets us started for round number two.
Round two.
Tina Curran's leg kicks have been lethal, and we expect to see more in this round.
Really showing some beautiful Muay Thai technique. Those leg kicks were absolutely tremendous. And now she's got full mount. Hip escape. Gets out of the full mount.
Got the mount again.
And the mount again.
She's in full mount again. Hip escape, nice hip escape.
Ah, that's an outstanding transition.
Postured up and threw it down with force.
The huge head kick is blocked.
Oh, there's a leg kick.
Big roundhouse kick.
Oh, that's a huge shot to the head.
Posture up. Nice leg kick by Harry. Harry with a good leg kick.
Beautiful leg kicks. That bruise on her outer thigh is getting much worse.
Strong kick by Curran.
Oh, that's a big stress.
Good kicks, Joe.
Nicely stuffed. Just over two on the clock.
Very good job of timing these punches.
Solid leg kick by Curran. Just misses with the left. Herrick with a strong kick. Inside leg kick by Herrick. That's a solid straight. Herrick with a strong leg kick.
Big left hand. The kick gets through. Takedowns in MMA are largely part of timing. And a high kick.
1 minute remains in the round. She's done a great job with the leg kick. Over and over.
And partner, these have been nasty. Nice leg kick.
Wow! Wow! That's a big right hand.
That's a huge punch.
It is all over! Just like that!
Wow.
Wow!
Ground and pound KO.
Once again, here's our fight replay.
Let's take a closer look at that from a different angle. Great angle here. Oh, man. KO.
With the official decision, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve DeBree, let's go to stop this contest. At 4 minutes, 35 seconds of round number two, declaring the winner by knockout. Police Lil Boot Harry!
Police Harry.
by knockout.
Next, it's a lightweight bout between Edson Barboza and former Strike Force champion Gilbert Melendez.
History.
El Nino, Gilbert Melendez.
Gilbert Melendez has it all. Knockout power, devastating ground and pound, outstanding wrestling, great jiu-jitsu as well as heart and determination.
Barboza makes his way out of the tunnel, and he looks very prepared for tonight's fight.
This guy has some of the best guard passing in all of mixed martial arts. His technique and the speed of his execution is outstanding.
Barboza, set to fight Gilbert El Nino Melendez. Our tale of the tape for this lightweight fight. The Brazilian is 30. The American is 33. Barboza is 2 inches taller. He will have a 2-inch reach advantage. And with the official introductions, here's the veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting and out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 22 wins, 5 losses. He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of San Francisco, California, USA, Gilbert! And now, introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. A mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 17 wins, 4 losses. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, Edson Junior Barboza. And the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta, our referee. Ready? Mike Goldberg, Joe Rogan.
We are set to get things started.
Tonight's fight is scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. White trunks for Melendez. Black trunks for Barboza.
Look out for Edson Barboza's kicks. They are vicious.
He connects with the straight. Barboza with a kick to the midsection.
These guys are going at it here right away, trading blows.
Good movement to the right.
Oh, another good body shot. Joey's really starting to do some damage.
That punch was blocked. There he goes with a 1-2.
Oh, just missed with the knee.
He tags him with the punch. He's really mixing things up tonight. Inside leg kick.
And a clinch. And he pulls away.
Nice roundhouse kick to the body. Melendez with the combination. Oh, he tagged him with that straight. Barboza with the block.
Push kick.
Barboza with the single leg.
One overhook, one underhook. He's got the double.
Melendez with the hook from the clinch.
And pummels under and out of double underhooks. Trips the leg and he's got him down.
Under two now.
He's got his back.
Great position.
He's got him mounted here.
He's got his back here, Joe.
Flattened him out. Left hand.
You're at half guard. You're all good there.
Transitions to side control.
He's in half guard here.
That's a big elbow, Joe.
Huge elbow.
Knee to the body.
He's doing a great job of moving and transitioning here on the ground. He's got the clinch.
That knee connects.
And he pummels out of it.
10 seconds remain in round one. He's in a better position here with the tie clinch.
Our first round is in the books.
Here's a perfect kick to the body. Here's a nasty head kick that lands. And here we see excellent timing with this trip. Incredible highlights in that round.
Brittany.
Okay, round two, you ready?
Round two. Edson Barboza's tenacity to take his opponent down at will was very impressive that round. It'll be interesting to see if he can continue to do it.
Yes, a very dominant round for him, Mike. It's going to be interesting to see whether or not he can keep that pace up.
Solid kick by Edson Barboza. And Joe, no one will ever forget how he finished Terry Adams. The amount of damage that has been done to his body makes you wonder if he's got a broken rib or two.
Nice shot.
Solid jab by Melendez. Oh, he lands the roundhouse to the body.
Trying to fight off a takedown here.
Big hook.
Melendez's hook is defended.
Into the clinch.
Engages the Muay Thai clinch. A clean knee to the head lands.
Damaging knee. Kick to the midsection. Oh, big body kick.
Look at this. Again with a solid kick to the body.
He connects with the left. Turning into an all-out slugfest.
Nice takedown.
Oh, beautiful sweep.
Looking for the rear naked choke. He's free from the rear naked choke. And he winds up on top.
In the half guard. Joe, he's showcasing some great movement on the ground. Good job getting back to over-under. Barboza's got double underhooks.
And from here, transitions to the Muay Thai clinch.
Now he's got him in the plum clinch.
Knees right here. He's got to get those knees to the body. Lands one.
Double underhooks here.
Nice knee inside.
Melendez gets him in the plum. He connects with the knee. They're working hard here in the clinch.
He moves to the Muay Thai clinch. Nice knee to the body.
Final seconds of the round.
And they disengage from the clinch.
And the end of the round.
Here's a big leg kick. Here's a nasty head kick that lands. Here's a perfectly placed leg kick. Amazing highlights from that round.
Not leave it in the hands of the judges, okay? This is it. You're losing this fight. You need to pull this out. Do not get in this guy's clinch, man. Stay out of his clinch. As soon as he clinches.
The lovely Ariani here tonight inside the United Center.
Last round, guys. You ready? You ready?
Let's go. 5 minutes left in the fight. Joe, that was a good round we just saw. It'll be very interesting to see if the fighters can keep this pace, though.
I think they will keep this pace. I think they're actually going to probably start turning it up a notch as we head down the home stretch.
And he parries it.
Beautiful knee.
Good kick to the leg of his opponent. Melendez gets caught with that left. Melendez again. Wow, look at those numbers. Body strikes landed.
Nice hook there.
Both men throwing frequently. Good inside leg kick by Melendez. Gilbert Melendez on his back. He connects with the punch. Barboza with a good right hand.
He lands an elbow here.
Barboza with another elbow.
Good punch. That eye is going to be grotesque. He's doing a great job of utilizing the ground and pound here. Really getting off some excellent shots.
He connects with a big punch from the top. Big right hand.
Excellent sweep. Moves to full guard. Sweet reversal. Right into the mount.
Looking for the armbar, looking for the finish. Almost had the armbar.
And full back.
The mount again.
He hip escapes. He's out of the full mount.
Thank you. Closing the distance. He's got the clinch, Joe.
He can do damage from this Muay Thai plum clinch.
His knees are a serious weapon here. Nice knee to the body.
Nice punch by Melendez.
He lands a huge elbow to the head.
Huge slam!
Seconds. Melendez gets it back to side control. They go the distance. What an outstanding fight. In a back and forth battle, both fighters were able to do damage utilizing ground and pound. But the question is, in the minds of the judges, who did more damage and who has earned the victory?
Incredibly close fight, incredibly exciting fight. And you're right, the ground and pound was the big story of this fight on both sides. Round three, looking to do some damage with the ground and pound, and this elbow finds the mark.
And here's Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. Judge one scores this contest, 29-28, Melendez. Judge two scores it, 9-28, Barbosa. And Judge 3 scores it, 30-27, for the winner by split decision, Edson Junior Barbosa!
Edson Barbosa earns the victory by split decision.
It's a UFC Women's Bantamweight Division fight.
She is very battle-tested, and from what at one point seemed so far away, is now within range, and that is a bantamweight belt. That is a UFC championship. She has fought some of the best. If she earns the victory tonight, she will leave with the belt.
As she makes her way to the octagon right now, her preparation has been perfect. She is in fantastic shape. She is focused. She is motivated. And she believes she will leave this cage tonight as the new champion of the world.
Holly Holm, making her way to the octagon. She is by far the most decorated female boxer in UFC.
knockout. She is an 18-time world champion and 2008 Fighter of the Year candidate with Floyd Mayweather and George Rush St. Pierre. Her full attention, though, now is on the sport of MMA and becoming one of the best to ever compete inside the octagon. Our tale of the tape for this bantamweight championship fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Herb D. The moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out United Center in Chicago, Illinois. It's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC Bantamweight Championship of the World.
This woman is a Muay Thai fighter, holding a professional record of 12 wins, 2 losses. She stands 5 feet 5 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Lima, Peru, presenting the challenger, Valentina Shevchenko. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a boxer, holding a professional record of 10 wins. 1 loss. She stands 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, USA! Presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the World, Holly the Preacher's Daughter!
This is for the championship. You can give me your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. You will have a clean fight. Touch gloves.
I am very fired up for this fight. It's been a long time coming. The fans have been anticipating this for a long time. And it is going to go down right now.
Here we go!
Remember, title fight, 5 5-minute rounds.
We've been witness to many great championship fights over the years, but few have garnered as much enthusiasm as this matchup. It is certainly safe to say that this may be one of the biggest championship fights of all time.
This is an absolutely massive world title fight. The implications are huge across the sport. This is about as important a championship fight as you will ever witness.
Man, she's utilizing her jab.
Excellent job of landing punches here.
Good leg kick.
Nice kicks.
Swing and a miss. Good defense and a left hook counter. Stopped nicely.
And now they clinch. She's got over under here. Oh, good body kick.
Just over 3 now. Nice leg kick.
Great exchanges. Good takedown defense. Very nicely done.
Side control.
Beautifully executed sweep.
Trying to get control here.
Nope, lost it. She's in half guard now. He's got over and under here.
Double under hooks.
Oh, big slam.
Oh, my goodness.
Inside control, tying up that arm, looking for the Kimura. She's going for the arm bar. was a deep arm bar, but a beautiful escape.
And into the guard.
What a huge right hand!
Wow, that's a big left hand.
Huge bomb from the top.
Good control, postures up.
Big power in the ground and pound.
15 seconds remain in the round.
Able to posture up and deliver some ground and pound.
That's the end of round number one.
Here we get a look at some of the action from that round. Here's a nasty ground and pound strike. And here is another ground and pound strike. And here's another powerful ground and pound strike. There was some really good ground and pound. And
you ready to fight? Ready.
Round two. The fight continues. The champion continues to look great. Once again, showcasing her superior skill set. If this fight continues to go like this, she'll leave with the belt.
Both hooks in.
Holmes going for the choke.
And she's out of the submission.
Great movement on the ground.
Full back hooks. She gets her back.
And the mount.
Full mount. Not good.
Man, both of her eyes have started to swell very badly. You've got to wonder about her vision.
Joe, she's staying busy on top.
Just over three now.
Big right hand.
Excellent posture.
Holmes got the full mount again. Holmes going for a submission attempt.
Had the armbar.
Solid strike to the head.
She's now back in full mount.
Damaging left hand.
Biggest elbow lands to the head.
Side control. Nicely done.
Knees are coming. And mount again. Full mount. Hip escape. Gets out of the full mount.
Holmes back in half guard.
Oh, big right hand.
Big ground and pound.
Big right hand.
Beautiful right hand.
45 seconds.
Oh, that's a good shot right there.
Very good shot.
30 seconds.
Full guard.
Oh, she's got an armbar here.
Wow, that was close.
Perfect round. I need you to go out there and do more of that.
Let's take another look at some of the action from that round. Here we see some beautiful technique executing this submission, but doesn't quite pull it off. And there's another excellent attempt at the submission, but can't quite finish it. And here is one more submission attempt. It looked very tight, but couldn't quite.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Third round of this championship fight.
Stuffed it. Stuffed it.
Home with the left. That knee to the body did some damage. Half guard.
Beautiful. Into mount. This fight very well may be stopped in between rounds just because of the blood loss, Mike, because that is extraordinary. Good shot to the head. Hip escape. Nice hip escape.
Solid ground and pound by Holm. Oh, she connects once again. And Joe, she does so right where her opponent is already.
Front kick, big to the kick landed. Vicious combination.
Man, that was a big strike. Big right hand.
Oh, big right hand. Wicked knockout here for the win.
Time now for our fight replay.
And let's take a look at the replay. This is the shot that drops her. Perfect technique. She's clearly hurt badly here. Let's take a look at it from another angle here. This is the one that causes the knockdown and the subsequent follow-up strikes for the knockout. Check out this angle here. Bam! And good night.
Here is Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Gaines called the stop to this contest at 1 minute, 30 seconds of round number 3. Declaring the winner by knockout! And still, the undisputed UFC bantamweight champion of the world, Holly and Peaches Buffer!
Holly Holm remains the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion. What a great night of fights. For my partner, Joe Rogan, this is Mike Goldberg.